I'm Estus Pirkle, and I'd like to tell you about the place called heaven. Heaven, the place where the Lord God Almighty dwells. Let us compare it to New York City. If the New Jerusalem were only 1,500 feet tall, like the tallest buildings in New York City, it would still be 1,400 times greater in size than New York City. This means that the New Jerusalem is over 5,000 times higher than New York City. This makes the New Jerusalem over 7 million times bigger than New York City. Does this excite you? Think about it. Does it not stagger the imagination? No builder on earth can conceive any structure to compare to the mansions above. Won't that be something when you go to live in your own mansion? There'll be no concern about paying for it. It's already taken care of. There'll be no worry of being moved out of it. It will be yours forever. Yet as glorious as the mansions are, there's something even more glorious to me in John 14, 2. Again we read, "Behold, I make all things new." This means there's no aging in heaven. In fact, age is unknown when we get our glorified bodies. Here we see a typical example. Wouldn't you enjoy living in a place like that?
Welcome home, beloved of God. Welcome to a place where sin and Satan cannot enter. Welcome to a place where death cannot come. Welcome to a place where loneliness is never felt. Welcome to a place where a holy God lives with a holy people.
Lord.
Welcome to heaven, where joy will be yours forever.
Again we read, "Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." Little Evelyn Talbert has experienced so much pain in her life. She's 54 years old, 32 inches tall, and has never walked one day in her life. But thank God, one day she will.
In a twinkling of an eye, I shall be caught up and shall be changed. Well, one of these days, I'm going to walk with my Lord. One of these days, I'm going to talk with my Lord. And when this life is o'er, I'll live forevermore on that bright celestial shore. One of these days.
And now, let me say a word to you who are watching this film. Have you made your plans as to where you will spend eternity? What would happen to you if Jesus should come back today? Or if you should get killed in an earthquake, or death should come in some other sudden form, where would you go? This could be God's last call to you.
I'm kind of like doubtful.